Yo, dog, you ready, brah?
Urban Bobby's back.
Yeah. Oh, are we opening with Urban
I'm
Bobby?
I'm chilling, shit, cuz.
Urban
it.
Bobby, yeah, would you like the countdown?
The roof, dog. Yeah, do the countdown, bro.
5, 4.
Welcome to the Tiger Belly. My name is Bobby, and we've got Khalyla, and we got Gilbert, and we got George as a pink dick. And welcome to the 51st episode Woo! Of our podcast.
Podcast.
And I just got back from Sacramento, and thank you for all the people from Tiger Belly showing up to the show, but it wasn't enough, and I'm never gonna go back. It was the worst weekend I've ever had there.
Why do you say worst?
Because I've been there, that Sacramento Punchline, probably 20 times in my life, and I usually do pretty well numbers wise. This was the worst I've ever done.
Well, the location of that place is upstairs next to a mattress store, so it's a little bit, you know, it's not conducive for business.
Yeah, and then they closed that Mongolian restaurant across the street, which I love. You ever been to a Mongolian restaurant?
Where they cook in front of you?
Yeah, where they have that gigantic thing. Mm-hmm. You know, I love that.
I bet you it's real fun. Mongolian. I bet you they don't even have that type of food.
I lived in Mongolia, and it is real.
How many years, sir?
20 years I lived in Mongolia.
Oh my gosh.
It's a pity you're not in the Marco Polo cast.
Wow, career attack right away.
Sorry, baby.
You know, I've had a really rough career week.
Yes.
Number one.
Why are you so excited, Khalyla?
No, because she likes
to rub it in my fucking eyes.
not your face,
she
but your
rubs
eyes.
It in my eyes.
Specifically your eyes.
No.
About a year ago, I auditioned for a show called Montauk.
Mm-hmm. What's that?
I'll just tell you what it is, dude. Mm-hmm. I go in and I play a teacher, and I did good. And then they call, they go, yeah, we were very interested in him. So they put me on hold for a couple of months, and then they go, you know what? We don't think that there's an, because it's a genre piece. So we don't think that we're Asians in the 80s. So we're going to hire Andrew Daly, who's a friend of mine. Mm-hmm. He was on Matt TV. I love Andrew. But then he couldn't do it. So they called me back to see what my availability was.
What do you say?
And I said, I'm available.
Yeah. Oh, I thought you were
going to they go, and then like another month went by, and they go, no, I think we're going to get a white guy. And the show's called Stranger Things now. You know what I mean? And as that teacher, and I didn't get it because of my gooky eyes.
You were supposed to be in Stranger Things.
Yeah.
I could have been in it, but I didn't get it. And it's like my gooky eyes.
Stop saying your gooky eyes.
Fucked me again.
Now, were there really no Asian teachers
in
Montauk in the 80s?
There were, but they sold opium.
They're just dealers
in
school.
Dealers, yeah. And they did laundry and stuff. But so then that happened, and then I get invited to do Oddball.
Big deal.
Right.
Big
Very
deal.
Big fucking deal.
But then
deal.
I look at the flyer and my name is in tiny little black. You know what I mean?
It's not red and bold.
The red and bold
ones.
They did bold ones?
Like Brian Regan.
Brian Regan. Sebastian. Gabriel Iglesias. Sebastian. Yeah, big red. And in tiny little black font.
I want to see it. You're exaggerating.
Look at it. Me, Ali Wong, little black font. Eliza Schlesinger's little black font.
That fan in red and bold.
Oh my God.
No, he's never going to be invited to that. I'm sorry. He's too good.
What if he was on there?
He's too. Oh, if he. Okay, let me just say something.
If he had a black name on there,
he would internally combust. He would die on the spot.
No, I wouldn't.
Like the rage.
I'm not in competition. I love the guy. What are you guys talking about? I'm a big fan.
So you would split an hour at Oddball with that fan.
Yeah,
30 Bobby, 30 Dead.
100%.
Okay. All right.
But yeah, I didn't get red font. That's fine. And then what else happened? Oh, and then I shot Mad TV last week.
Cool.
How was it?
It was all right, but one of the scenes was Ike Barinholtz gives two of the cast members a tour of his dressing room. Mm-hmm. And they're like, oh my God, it's Ike giving us a tour. And then there's a little thing on the wall that like a thing opens. Mm-hmm. And I'm living in there. And I've gotten feral. And basically what happened was when the show got canceled, I got stuck in the wall.
Oh, there's a big storyline behind it?
Yeah, yeah. I got stuck in the wall.
You have to see
it. And I've gone completely feral. But then I think, you know what? since Mad TV, I could have probably just stayed in that wall. It's pretty much the way my career has gone.
Not really.
It has.
Oh, come really? On,
That's what the joke was.
Well, if you're in a wall, would you be?
That's what the fucking joke. They wrote it that way. You know who wrote the sketch? John Barinholtz.
Oh.
Ike's brother.
So the Barinholtz right? just have it out for you?
Fucking threw me on the fucking bus. So then I have long hair. I'm dirty.
To Adam Ray's Instagram, mm-hmm. and there's a video of it there.
It is?
Yeah, it's so funny.
Of me doing what?
I watched it probably 80 times.
What was
times.
I doing in it?
You just please watch it. Oh. You were feral, and yeah, you're like, yeah. I'm trying to get a job here.
Yeah.
Your fingernails are all dirty.
Yeah. So my point is that, and then
oh god,
it gets worse. It gets really worse. So then I don't want to rip on anybody. No, I don't want to rip on anybody.
I'm not gonna rip on anybody.
And then I went to the Sacramento Punchline this weekend. It was pretty bad. So I've had a tumultuous week, but you know what, guys? I'm not gonna give up.
Boom.
I'm gonna do the oddball as Black Font.
Stop saying Black Font.
I'm gonna go I'm gonna host Mad TV next Friday with Ike live.
Next Friday, this Friday.
This coming Friday, I mean live.
Yeah. Are we going? Can we?
You're gonna go.
Can Gilbert and Georgie come with me?
If they wanna come, they can come.
Yeah.
100%. You can be my auntie.
Yeah. Ooh, the entourage.
And then, but you're going to come to Oddball, Khalyla, because people have been requesting to do a little vlog when I'm there backstage, because I'm going to have a panic attack.
Oh, okay, sure thing.
Cool.
You know what I mean? So you're going to do that, and then...
Wait, why are you going to have a panic attack at Oddball?
Because it's, I never do well in front of more than 10,000 people in a crowd.
Oh, I thought you killed that one giant crowd, that all black show. You said you came
Where?
You said you bombed, but then you did it again and you killed. It's some story you were telling.
Yeah, it's the same.
That's when he followed Leslie Jones.
Yeah.
The
first time and I bombed. And then the next week, it's fine. It's just difficult. Mm. Okay, Gabriel. What's your name?
You've been calling me Gabriel for the past month.
What's your name
I'm
again?
Not Gabriel Iglesias, man.
Gilbert.
I'm Filipino.
Gilbert.
Yeah.
Hey, I have a cousin named Gabriel, and he's the one who molested me when I was 8.
Whoa,
he's Filipino.
Too soon.
That was
That's
way
fucking
too
uncomfortable.
Soon. How old are you?
Yeah, he finger blasted
he
me.
He blasted your little veggie?
While I was
veggie?
Asleep. Yeah, he...
How do you know then? What was the dream?
Because I woke up, and my panties were down, and then his
look
fingers
at George,
were inside
me. Look at George,
me.
Look at how concerned he is.
Concerned or excited?
And then I was so concerned. And it was painful, and I woke up from the pain.
But you want to hear pain?
What?
The worst pain of all of it combined, mm-hmm. all right, was I wasn't invited to George's party.
Wow. Why? I have a question.
So George has a party because he's leaving Maker.
Mm-hmm.
You guys were invited, correct?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Everyone
and
was
I
invited.
Wasn't invited, and it really just kind of stung, like a spiritual rape myself.
Wow.
It really hurt my heart. And you're my producer for this. I feel like I brought you in here.
All my friends were invited.
And I wasn't invited. Why, George?
Maybe because you haven't responded to the last 15 emails I sent.
Wow.
Yeah, but I don't.
Oh.
Yeah, I don't need to. I don't need to respond.
I begged and pleaded to get on this, and then finally, 2 months later, Khalyla messages me on Instagram.
Yeah. But based on my okay, though, George.
I heard too, Bobby.
So what you're saying?
He was
what
hurt.
You're saying
he was hurt.
Is this is a revenge?
Yes.
Non-invite.
Yes.
No, but she doesn't. And I wasn't invited, and that's 1-1.
Why is it 1? Oh, okay.
Because I didn't respond to his emails mm-hmm. and all that stuff over the years, and I think it's 1-1. And hurt by it, but that just shows your character, and that's fine. Hurt by it, but you need to...
Ton of hot guys there, baby.
I bet.
Whoa.
Oh, and here's another thing, bitch. Ooh.
Fighting words.
Yeah, and you wait, George, you're going to bring Italians over there to fucking hit on my fucking girl at the fucking party?
Italians.
There was like 6 Italians that tried to rape my fucking girlfriend at your party, dude.
Whoa.
Whatever they were.
Spaniards.
Hey, anybody. Hey, listen, anybody, Italians, you European guys, she's fucking taken, man.
By a Korean,
he doesn't
son.
Fuck me often,
yeah.
but I'm taking.
Do we not fuck like an hour?
It
ago?
Wasn't called fucking.
Ooh.
I don't. In what world is that considered fucking?
I stick my dick in your vagina?
Yeah, but it was like a...
Khalyla, he fucked you.
He called... You know what he does? He was like singing this song called Make It Spread 2016.
Okay, time out. Whoa.
Yeah, Make It Spread 2016. I'd like to hear the whole
song.
Yeah, and...
I forgot. Make It Spread 2016.
Bobby, stop.
And then I spread her cheeks open.
Like, really? But isn't
it... And I pulled her pants down and started like digging her vagina and pumped it a couple
times.
It was
still dry and it was...
It was rapish.
It was.
It was good.
But was it sex?
He was such a deep creep. Like, deep creep.
Deepy creepy.
Make It Spread 2016.
Creepy daddy. That was so wrong what you did to me earlier.
Oh, we'll call the police then.
Or some Italian men. I don't know.
Yeah, we'll call Italian. Let me say, bitch, I'm going to tell you something right now. You get Italian men to fuck you, and I know, right? You'll see what happens to those Italian men.
George didn't stop it, babe. He just watched.
I know he
did. As a matter of fact, he took pictures about this of us. Maybe he was trying to send you the pictures. Like, hey, look what your girl's up to.
Uh-oh.
So let me say something to you, George, okay? Why don't we start here? You just tell me all your resentments, all right, about... Because I feel like you have resentments toward me. And I will apologize for them. And then no more of these games that you play. You start inviting me to your parties, and you start having Spanish people try to fuck my fucking girlfriend, okay? So tell me exactly what you have resentment toward me about, and I will clarify and I will apologize. Go ahead.
Get on the mic, George.
Come here. I need to hear this. It needs to be recorded.
Because Gabriel ain't saying shit last couple podcasts.
Well, Gabriel also is having the worst week of his life because he got into a huge accident, which we'll talk about after George. Right. Talk about bad week.
Go ahead.
Just professional resentment. It's hard to get notes out of you, man. It's hard to, like, I try to respect you. I try not to, like, email you or call you, like, late or text you.
Yeah.
But then all the days at Maker, I had so many big dreams. I don't have resentment now because I can text Khalyla and we can make things happen.
Uh-huh.
So it's kind of hard to have resentment when things are
so
moving.
So when I was at Maker and you were my producer, that's when you had the resentment.
Yeah, it was hard to get a hold of.
Hard to get a hold of me.
Mm-hmm. We had lots of videos that
lots
we just
of
needed,
videos that we needed to do.
That right? were brilliant, that the world
brilliant,
needed to
brilliant
see.
Brilliant ones, brilliant ones.
Yeah.
So me doing road dates and Animal Practice and Dictator and Harold Kummer. Just Ooh. Shut the fuck up, all right?
His name is Credits Guy.
Not Credits, no, but during that time period is when I was doing all those things, right? In the last 5 years, yes, I have probably worked the least out of anyone from Mad TV, but I still fucking worked. And when I'm on a set with a real movie, I ain't gonna do YouTube, bro.
But listen to this. You don't leave people hanging. That's just the principle of life.
No, you know what? Get out of the thing. Go back, Gabriel.
I quit my job for you, Bobby.
Yeah, I know you did. Oh, wow. I know you did. Yeah. I know you did. And thank you.
Thank you for the pressure.
Thank you for the pressure.
Yeah.
No, why is your day week bad?
He got fucking T-boned and nearly died this past weekend in Chicago.
You know what they say when you get hit in an accident? Everything slows down.
Yeah.
It actually does.
Uh-huh.
But everything's a blur.
He has a huge welt on his leg, and he showed me the wreck, and it was a...
Who was driving?
It was a hit and run, so I didn't know.
You were driving your own car?
Rental car, which is fucking worse.
Okay, so you're driving a rental car, and somebody hit you from behind?
No. They hit me front passenger side, so I spun a 180. They basically ran a red light. They hit me on the right. I spun, and they took off. Some guy was just like, yo, my God, just took off. You dead, man? I got out of the car. Oh, I don't know why. I was telling her, I got out of the car so angry because of the adrenaline. I had to kick the door because it was stuck. I kept yelling. It was just raining.
Yeah.
And I just found out the guy wasn't there. And that really took forever. It just headaches.
Gilbert, if you died, we would be shattered beyond repair.
I want to hear Bobby say it.
Devastated.
I'm going to... Gosh.
He would? He's
No, I'm trying to figure out how would it feel.
Oh, fuck you.
No, I'm being real. I want to do the most honest thing.
Okay.
Tell me that Gilbert died in an accident.
Baby.
Yeah.
You need to sit down for this.
What?
I just got a text.
From who?
From Gilbert's mom.
Who's that?
Babe, Gilbert.
Gabriel?
Yeah, Gabriel, the guy on the third mic.
Oh, yeah, he's cool. What happened?
He died.
Gilbert's mom died?
No. Gabriel, Gilbert himself.
Himself died?
Yes.
And then what happened? What else
so
happened?
Many questions.
Yeah.
That made me feel weird doing that. I don't actually want to do that.
Yeah, it's not going to ever fucking happen.
I never want to actually ever say that. that felt weird.
But I used to always say, I'll never get in an accident because I've never been in an accident before.
I've been in a million. That's part of life.
Yeah.
He hit and runs.
I hit and run. I've been running. Hit.
Why you got to hit and run?
I've done all kinds of stuff.
No, but he does like
small hit and runs.
Yeah,
oh,
small
like
hit
serious.
And runs. Like he hits their bumper
if it's,
and then
if
he'll
it's
just
a bumper,
drive away.
If it's a bumper to bumper and it's a white person, oh, you dented my BMW, right? And they pull over, I just drive by.
You're good.
It's stupid. It's
you even
ridiculous.
Say hi.
I don't even say hi. I just gotta memorize my license plate. I'd rather go to prison. I'm being real, all right?
What?
You didn't die, yeah. And I don't know what you're saying, okay? Mm-hmm. So yeah. I'm sorry that you...
Can we talk about my bad week?
What happened?
What the fuck happened to you, bitch?
Before we get to your bad week, can I have a question?
Yeah.
I was walking in the kitchen, and there's like a shitload of toothpaste and toothbrushes.
Okay.
Are you guys donating?
No.
Here's
the thing. I'm glad you noticed that. And I'm glad that I'm not the only one that has to deal with the situation now.
Oh, God.
It's a group thing?
So drama.
It's not drama. Khalyla, there's two things... Okay, she's a normal person.
Yeah.
Okay, that's right. She's not. But she hoards two things. Mm-hmm. She hoards water and fucking toothpaste. If you buy her the biggest size toothpaste, one day it's gone. I'm not even kidding you. Right? So I bought 20 boxes the other day because I'm fucking tired of going into the fucking bathroom. And having, you know what she did the other day? I bought a toothpaste. She used it in 2 days. Then she filled water into the tube to make it seem like, you know what I mean?
Like,
there's some still left.
Like Bobby won't notice.
Yeah,
that.
Yeah,
yeah.
That's what fucking hoarders do. And people with diseases.
Khalyla.
Look, I can explain. One of my favorite things to do to decompress when I'm in the shower is to... put a shit ton of toothpaste on a toothbrush, sit there, think, and chew. I chew down. That's why
you don't even
I
brush?
Go through toothbrushes once a week. I get one every week. I just sit there and I chew like a fucking dog teething.
Yeah.
And it's one of my ways. It's a coping mechanism. I've been doing this since I was younger. And you can always tell if you walk into a bathroom which one my toothbrush is because it's the one that's just completely like dilapidated.
Yeah.
And this is since you've known her.
Yeah, with the whole water thing, I think...
I hide bottles of water. I'm not even kidding you. I hide them under the bed.
Is that why we always have so much water here?
And she finds them all the time, and she drinks all my water.
I have an obsession with water. I need to always touch it.
It's crazy.
Have panic attacks when I don't have like a bottle of water next to me. I think that I spent most of my life in the water. Twice, I did 2 days for 15 years. I need to be... I take 2 showers a day, and I know it's a California drought, but... it's for my sanity, and I just if I could sleep with a finger inside a cup of water, I would.
Okay.
Yeah, I might have a problem.
No, she definitely has one.
I get why you bought all that now. It makes sense.
And I drink probably, I'd say, 8 of these a day.
I'm not even kidding you. That's the truth.
Yeah.
And it's like, dude, it's like all my money is going into water.
Bottled water. It's
bottled
free.
Water.
Water's free.
You know, what are you drinking right now?
I have extreme anxiety.
Spilled all over.
What are you drinking right now?
It's coconut water. That
Where'd
Roxy.
You get that at?
Roxy.
Oh, there's this. Okay, our fan Roxy.
Roxy, super. Yeah. I am a Roxy.
Okay, the reason why my left leg is numb is because of the fact that she's been sending candy. I swear to God. Candy, ice cream, all kind of fucking shit. Right? Yeah. My left leg is completely numb now from diabetes.
Are you serious?
Yeah. I think this bitch is trying to kill me.
She knows you'll eat it.
I think she's trying to feed us, but kill
why
you.
Why can't she just send us healthy things?
Coconut water is very healthy.
But she also sends gummy bears and stuff.
But she does
Bobby
send us
loves
all our treats.
I love gummy bears and all that
and
stuff.
And she sent us a huge bag of Hi-Chews.
Ooh.
Which are your favorites?
I love Hi-Chews, man.
Yeah.
They're my fucking favorite. But look at this right here. These gummy bears are from her.
Yeah, everything. She said Kit Kats.
Yeah.
The strawberry Kit Kats from Hong Kong,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah.
She sent those too.
Yeah.
I love her. Please keep sending us
Thanks,
food.
Roxy.
But can we talk about my bad week?
Go ahead.
Or is that going to take down the whole podcast? Because mine's like real life. I mean, not to say your accident wasn't, but you're alive. You know?
No, his accident wasn't real life. I don't feel bad about it.
I don't. I'm trying to move past it.
There's nothing to move past.
Sweetie, he's traumatized.
Who gives a fuck? Now you tell me yours.
Thanks.
I'm sorry. What, George? You have something to say?
Thanks, Admiral.
I am in a bad mood right now.
You're not.
Grumpy.
Why?
Well, tell me the bad day.
Well, I didn't have a chance to talk about it last podcast because we had a guest and I didn't want to bring down the energy, but my stepdad, Roger, had a massive heart attack.
Oh.
And he almost died. And it was 3 days of just hell because he went in initially to for chest pain, and his blood work was positive for, you know, something that for troponin. His troponin was positive. And so I told him, I was like, look, you cannot leave here. Your troponin is elevated. It means your heart has sustained some type of damage. But Kaiser discharged him because they didn't fucking, oh God, I'm so done with Kaiser. They sent him home with elevated troponin. And it's such a huge marker for a possible heart attack. So he went in and out of the emergency room for 3 days, and they kept telling him, oh, it's just heartburn. It's just heartburn. It's just heartburn. And I kept, my sister and I kept telling them, it's not heartburn. Can you do an echocardiogram? Can you do further tests? No, we don't. It's not blah, blah, blah. They gave us a fucking runaround all weekend. Finally, Monday morning, he had full blast heart attack to the point where he needed to go and get surgery within 40 minutes. He was in and out of surgery within 40 minutes. It was awful. He had 100% occlusion in his like main artery. That shit really scared me, you know?
You and your sister are going to tear the hospital apart?
I mean, I'm not. I mean, I told him to, you know, like I like to respect my boundaries with like medical professionals. But I mean, it's just really frustrating when you have to, even when you advocate for someone, they still do it wrong. Mm-hmm. And I was just really scared because Roger has been like my dad for the past 15 years, you know? So I was terrified and really upset, and I needed to just get that out of my chest, and I think we're all having a bad week. But I'm glad that we're here together.
George had an amazing week.
George has had an amazing week.
What happened?
Fuck you, George.
Why is your week so amazing?
I quit my job.
He quit his job for us, baby.
Ready to rock and roll.
But we need to make money, though. Now, by you quitting your job,
no one has
it puts so much pressure on us to make you fucking money, dog.
A motherfucking kingmaker.
He's a kingmaker.
Wow. Wow. I love it.
Great.
He's manifesting it in
his
life.
How great is it that he has that much belief in us?
It's great.
That he's going to quit a senior producer maker. Good job, Georgie. Good job.
Did they try to hold on to you, or?
I told them they couldn't.
Wow.
But Terica, was she at your party?
Nope, she didn't show up to that one.
Mm-hmm. But she was invited, babe.
She was invited? Terica?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Do you like her?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's cool. but you're my favorite from there. Don't laugh like a little schoolboy.
She did a hee hee hee.
Yeah. No, I really, you're one of my favorites from there.
You know who's having even a worse week than us?
Who?
Did you guys see that video of that tiger mauling in China?
No.
So, I mean, I don't know why I'm laughing. It's really fucked up. But look at the video online. Some woman, I guess, gets into an argument with... They go into a safari park. You know when you do those safaris where you shouldn't even roll your windows down. You just go through it and they're like wild tigers around you or whatever. She gets into an altercation, I guess, with the other person in the car. She gets out of her car, goes to the passenger side, and a fucking tiger just mauls her, like grabs her. And carries her off of the thing. And then a second person who was inside the car goes and tries to save her. Stupid. Gets mauled by a second tiger and
don't
then
get
gets mauled
the
to death.
Wait. Don't get out the car.
They got out of the fucking car.
Were they in the zoo?
It was, yeah. It's like a zoo, but you know those wildlife safari parks where you've never been
in
to
China?
Those?
China? Yeah, I've been to when it's in Africa. I've been to them.
Okay, good.
I have.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Well, you're not supposed to get out of the fucking car.
Don't get
car.
Out of the fucking car.
Rule number one, don't leave the fucking car.
Like, when we were in the Jeep in Africa, they're like, there were the lions. I go, well, cool, but I'm not leaving the car.
Yeah.
Why did they leave again?
Because they got into an altercation. Like, let's say you and I were fighting in the car. I'm like, yo, fuck you, Bobby, whatever. I got out of the car.
Yeah, we're not getting out of the car.
No, you fight in the car.
Child lock.
Or just go, hey, let's continue this fight when there aren't fucking tigers around.
Yeah. Let's fight at the hotel.
Yeah. I know you're mad, sweetie, right? Because I'm playing too much Destiny. Right and whatnot, but can you say it when we're inside a hotel, not where there's fucking tigers around? You know,
you have to watch the video, babe.
I don't want
to
watch.
She got dragged.
It. She died.
The second lady who tried to save her died.
Oh my!
Chinese though.
Chinese. There are too many of those, right? You don't feel as
bad. Why are you laughing? Why are you laughing?
Because you smiled.
I didn't smile.
Oh, there's a camera. Let's
zoom
up on that
crying.
Smile.
Oh, he's crying.
Chinese died.
Speaking of crying, what's with these snaps of Bobby always having to massage your leg?
He pays to play.
Is that a real currency?
It really is, and it's fucking bullshit.
It's gonna happen tonight too.
Not gonna happen tonight. Do you know why?
He pays in massages.
Do you know why it's not gonna happen tonight?
Why?
Because I came into, okay, let me just say something right now. I've been so fucking busy, all right? The fucking Iron Banner is going on, all right?
Explain.
Iron Banner is a thing. It's a tournament that only happens once a month. And because I was busy this week, I couldn't participate. It ends at 2 in the morning tonight, and I haven't finished it yet. Mm-hmm. And if I would have, now my plan was to fly home, which I did this morning from Sacramento. I thought she would be sleeping. I would play all day long, all night long, right? And then, boom, I would finish it. But I wasn't able to do that. Because as soon as I did one game, she was mad at me.
I wasn't mad. Here's the deal with it. I ask you, how many hours do you need to play tonight? Because I can go to my sisters. I can do things. Listen.
No.
But this is what's unreasonable about you. I asked you today. I was like, Bobby, tell me what our day looks like. How many hours do you need to play Destiny? He goes, 60. He needs 60 hours today.
In one day?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He asked for 3 days in one day.
Oh, man.
Because it ends at 2, yeah. and I'm hungry, but I'm literally thinking, maybe I'm not going to eat because I have to finish this thing.
Sacrifice.
I mean,
the cats didn't eat either. So.
Yeah, it's that important to me.
No one ate.
You know? It's that important to me. Mm-hmm. And you might think it's an addiction. It's not. It's a game, and I want to finish it.
Why's your smile getting bigger?
I don't know why. You know?
What happens
if you... And the reason why I spread her cheeks earlier and penetrated her fucking dry vagina is out of punishment.
Okay, I get it.
That was punishment.
Yeah, it was punishment. For sure it was.
And then just when I was kind of sort of getting into it...
I stopped.
He stopped.
Second punishment.
Second punishment.
Yeah, you don't get the juice.
Yeah.
Just as
I was getting like a little bit moist, he was like, okay, that's enough.
No, you don't get my inner juice. My inner juice is the sanctum of life.
Ooh.
Yeah, it's life juice.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay. And when you taste it, you taste pure life.
Like a baby?
No. It's like what?
It's like a stem cell?
No, it's not like stem cell. I want to tell you what it is. When God created Adam, mm-hmm. right? And before Eve, you know, and that stuff that made Adam.
Stem cells.
But it's pure life, my fucking jizz.
It's like,
and you know what? Women beg for it.
Oh God,
they do. They go, can we have your life essence?
They yell at you in public.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Damn, dude,
you cannot have it. It's a gift. Okay,
it's only bottled.
If I bottled it and I sold it in the fucking black market, we'd be millionaires.
Oh wow!
It gets rid of like carpal tunnel if you drink it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Flat feet. Yeah. No longer have flat feet.
You all of a sudden grow arches.
If you're colorblind, you're just going to see colors again.
Dude, this is revolutionary.
Yeah, my sperm has all kinds of benefits that people don't realize.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You'll grow hair back on your head.
Okay.
You know? And that's why, like, one girl ate my cum all the time, and she grew a beard.
I think that was a man.
She could have been a man.
Could have been a man.
But my point is that my cum has... so many benefits to it, right? And I've been to doctors and scientists,
yeah,
and they've studied it. You know what it does if it hits fucking metal?
What?
It melts like alien blood in the movie Aliens.
Whoa! So it also has powers.
It has powers too. Yeah, and she wanted it inside her. She wanted my fucking life juice inside her.
But you punished her,
and I punished her, and I reframed, because if she would have been cool. And as soon as I came in, it's like, you play as long as you want today because I know that the Iron Banner ends at 2 and it's going to completely go away. And all the work that you've worked on, it's going to completely go away. I would have been like, all right, you'll get a little bit of juice inside you, which would probably, you know what I mean, give her benefits.
Yeah.
There's vitamins and probiotics.
Your heart will heal this pimple right there.
That pimple right there, yeah. But bitch, you don't get juice for a while.
Man.
What is the punishment if he doesn't massage you?
He doesn't get to play.
That's it?
It's bullshit.
This is fucking pay to play system.
Why is it pay to play?
Because if I don't demand that from you, I won't fucking see you.
Okay, can I just say this?
I don't want to just coexist in a home. I want to have a relationship with you.
I
want to
say something right now, and this might cause a fight.
It probably will. All right, it's okay. We've been fighting all week anyway.
I'm
going to
say something very factual.
Okay.
And I'm going to say something that I believe... that I love Khalyla more than she loves me.
This is going to be bad.
It's controversial.
Bullshit.
No, shut up. Let me say what I have to say. Okay.
You think you love me more than I love you.
I already know. It's a fact.
Breathe, Khalyla, breathe.
I'll tell you why it's a fact. Because Khalyla loves
sure
going
have
to.
A funny way of showing.
Can I just
love.
Say it? Can I just say it? Yeah. What I'm going to say?
Yes.
You get your rebuttal.
You love going to the beach, yeah. correct?
Yeah.
If you said to me one day, "Hey, Bobby, I'm going to go to the beach every day for 10 hours a day, 12 hours a day, every day for a year," mm-hmm. I'd be like, "You know what? I'm not going to see you as often, and that sucks, but I support it because I want you to be happy. You love the beach? Go to the beach. Yes, I'll be hurt and I'll miss you and my heart will shatter, but do it. It's not vice versa with video games, is it?" Mm. I love video games, mm-hmm. right? But there's conditions.
Massaging.
Bullshit,
yeah,
Bobby.
So I love her
Who
more.
Who the fuck, when the fuck would anyone, why would anyone spend more than 5 hours at the beach? You spend 12 hours a day.
Okay, all right. What do you like? What do you love doing?
Say spending time with Bobby.
Yeah, that's one of them.
Oh my wow. God. You know what? If I had a rope around my neck, I would pull it and I'd be hanging right now. All right? You know what I'm saying. Okay? Dog? You guys know exactly what I'm saying, dog. Mm-hmm.
Play. You know? I just don't want us to become that like, you know, I don't want to become that functional couple that
We're
just coexists.
We don't coexist.
Yeah, we do sometimes, babe. It's like, you know, we work well together. We're really good at communicating. All of these things are perfect. But in terms of just, we just don't have a, we don't.
I understand.
We don't connect enough.
I know. That's what.
We don't huggable.
In your feminine way, that seems like a problem. But let me just say this right now, okay? My parents were together for 40 years plus. No, 50 years now,
that's
right?
Long. That's really long.
There was a time where my dad used to knock my mom's teeth out with his fists. Mm-hmm. He used to get drunk and beat the living shit out of her to the point where he could have been arrested. You know what I mean? And those were dark times for my mom, but she hung in there.
She hung in there.
Is that what I have to look
She gets an award.
So what I'm saying is that award. In every relationship, there are good years, bad years, ups and downs, okay? I happen to be going through a destiny phase.
Look, motherfucker, I'm hanging.
A phase. Let's call it a phase. It's just a phase.
Yeah, yeah.
Look, I told you, what did I tell you last week? I'm not going anywhere.
I know.
I will fight
yeah.
and tooth and nail to yeah. make this work.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't care. Even if you tried to leave me, I would try to find a way to make it work. I'm not.
But
look, you also have, you know, to all make right. concessions of you know, once in a while.
Okay.
You know, instead of 12 hours.
No.
Maybe one of, you know, okay.
I think 12.
It's not 12 hours, first of all. That's
ridiculous. It's 12.
Ridiculous.
That no, shit it's is
ridiculous. That's ridiculous.
It's 12 and higher.
All right, it's not 12 and higher.
It's
okay?
ridiculous.
It's just that there are times when Trials of Osiris and the Brotherhood, you know, I mean, the Iron Banner's going on, and there's only a little window to play, and you have to get the prize. And it's not me. It's that they set it up that way, Bungie, to get me addicted. And I'm addicted to it. And my brother's addicted. Everyone's addicted to it. And I was out, but they pulled me back in. Mm-hmm. And for right now, I'm going through a phase. Okay? And I'm hungry. I haven't eaten all day.
How long does this phase last? I just want to prep myself. I want to prepare my soul.
Answer it honestly, too. How long is the phase?
I don't know. And that's the best answer I can fucking give you, Gabriel. And I, you know what? By your tone, you're on her side.
He is.
No,
thank
you're not.
You.
Everyone, every guy in this room should be on my fucking side.
You know why they're not on your side?
Why?
It's because we sit here and we wait here for a fucking hour for you to get your ass off the couch and start the podcast.
Or
in the meantime,
they're not on my side because they're fucking gay and they don't have fucking girlfriends. What do you think of that? I'm on to you two. All right, uh-huh. You both dick sucking.
Be careful.
I got your back, Bobby. Well,
Bobby, I got your back so hard, dog.
Right,
I'll
so
suck
sorry.
Your dick for it.
All right, so guys.
Gilbert has a special lady in his life. You don't know that.
Who is it?
And she's Asian.
Jessica?
No. Oh.
I think Jessica is for...
Who is it?
I'm just a girl I'm talking to right now.
Do I know her?
No.
You don't know her.
Give me a photo.
It's in the new...
No photos
It's the
right
beginning
now.
Phase.
No, no.
Very beginning phase. No
We're
photo.
Not going to ruin it for him
I'm
like
not
we did with Kentucky Four, babe.
I do want to say this.
No, remember, no. You're not going to switch the topics. You're not going to sway me
no,
this
I'm,
way.
No, I'm telling you, but...
Tell me why.
He cares.
No.
You care?
No, no. That, this is more important. Remember
okay.
what you guys told
yeah.
me in like episode
yeah.
something early on? Date an Asian girl?
Yeah.
I'm trying it.
Yes.
Let me tell you something.
Yeah.
There's something different about it.
I love it.
The cultural understanding of things.
Yeah. And I love the way you shifted the tempo of the direction of the thing so that I don't see a photo.
No photo.
She doesn't have social media.
There's not a single photo online about
No. I'm sure there's something on a Facebook, but no photos.
We're also not going to, we're going to make, I'll show you later.
No, if I don't see a photo right now, I'm going to be, cut it off. Cut the thing off.
It's not off.
If I don't see a photo right now, I don't think that I can move on because it's one of my OCD things.
I see. Oh, you know, he needs to see a photo.
I can't show a photo. I'll show you later.
I'll show you later. We're switching this off.
Okay, it's fine.
Okay.
Thanks for listening to Tiger Belly.
You think I'm kidding, but...
I'm not kidding either. I'm not kidding either. Baby,
get the fucking photo. Sit the fuck down.
I don't want to show a photo.
Show me the photo.
I don't want to show you... Now you're sitting back down. Okay.
I'm not sitting back down. Do you see me sitting back down?
Okay, it's done. It's done. It's done.
Can you sit the fuck down? He cares about this girl, and can you not ruin it for somebody?
And here's my evidence. Because I will not let this girl that I'm talking to be body shamed by a celebrity.
Body shame? We didn't body shame Sarah.
No, just I don't want to
talk... Is she fat?
What if she is? Is that a problem for
no.
you?
No.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Well, then that's why I'm not showing you photos.
She's not fat. She's very pretty.
She's 400 pounds.
She's chunky.
You, look, here.
Oh, right, listen.
I'm going to say, no.
You know
let me
what?
Say
You're
this.
Not the only one who,
no, let me say this.
Who has a problem with him doing this.
No,
because,
can I just say this? Yeah. I want to treat you guys, it's going to sound weird like my parents. It's going to sound weird. It's going to sound really good with it.
Yeah.
Because my mom has always told me that. She's like, never, ever bring a girl home. I don't care if you're dating her or whatever, unless she is the one.
Yeah.
Then you can introduce me to her. All the other girls is just white noise. Give me a couple months and find out.
Yeah.
Then I'll introduce you to Papa and Mama.
Okay. All right.
Thank you, Gilbert.
Okay, that's fine.
And also, all you would ever need to say to me is, look, she's special. I care about this girl, and I would show you the most utmost respect. Yeah, maybe I do take a couple digs at other girls that you've been with because they're throwaways. And I know you don't think they're that special.
I agree.
And they're not impressive. So obviously, I'm going to give you my most honest opinion. But even if, suppose, I'm not fully impressed by this girl, but if you loved her and you cared about her, I would only show respect to you and her. I would never fucking say anything bad about her in this podcast. He would, on the other hand. Anytime his brother comes to him and says, Bob, I met this girl. Show me a picture. No. And then there's this 30-minute whole thing. Show me a fucking picture. Same thing that's going on right now. Finally, Steve shows him a picture. First thing he says is, yuck. Yuck. You get inside that?
Wow.
Yeah, he's
Bobby.
Awful. He's awful. So I understand where you're coming from and never show him a picture.
I'll introduce when the time's right.
Yeah. Come on, baby. Be nice. Just be happy for him.
It's an Asian man. This is a big step
in
my life.
Is she in comedy?
No.
She's not an actress?
She's a civilian.
In the entertainment industry.
She's an agent.
No.
She's not, right?
I'll just say this. Producer. That's it.
Oh, okay.
Ooh, fancy.
I know. Very ambitious.
All right, fine. I don't care anymore.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah,
I don't care anymore.
What else do you guys want to talk about today?
What do you mean? Why are you?
What was that?
I'm trying to switch the subject.
Why?
Because I can feel Gilbert, you know, feeling serious about this.
Yeah,
thanks.
I just want to say this though before we end this fucking thing. I don't know how. We probably have a long way to go, but I don't care. I have to get this out of the way. Is that you motherfuckers that have been calling Leslie Jones gorilla and all that fucking bullshit is bullshit? Okay.
Awful.
Listen to me. Listen, no, just be quiet. Listen to me, okay? I've been in LA for 20 fucking years, and I've been at the Comedy Store for 20 fucking years. I've known Leslie for that long, and she's struggled for a very long time, okay? She was at a point where she couldn't pay her bills at sometimes, and she's just been up and down. She couldn't eat for many, many years. And she's stressed out and whatnot. And at the age of 48, she finally fucking makes it. And then you call her a gorilla on Twitter? First of all, I'm going to say this. When I did that gig in San Jose where I bombed, I had to follow Leslie Jones. This is about 8-9 years ago. She was good then. She was a beast. Chris Rock knew it. Everyone knew it. Okay? So anyone calling her that is fucking crazy. You're racist.
There are a ton of racist people. I mean, a lot of people cannot accept that, number one, a woman is making it that big, but a black woman, especially, is a Ghostbuster. Like, that just
That's
doesn't sit well Why? With a lot of simpletons. It just
doesn't.
There was
doesn't. A black guy that she... There was a black guy in the Ghostbusters, in the first one.
Imagine the vitriol that a woman like Leslie... experience this. If even me doing a simple podcast that doesn't even compare, it's not even a blip compared to the notoriety and the fame that Leslie mm-hmm. Jones is experiencing. Imagine if I receive a lot of hatred, if I receive hate mail, if I receive essays from people on the fucking hilarious morning of the 4th of July just trying to hurt my feelings, imagine the vitriol that she feels. Yeah, it blows my mind. And you know what? I don't blame her for leaving Twitter. That is a toxic, toxic, toxic place for anybody. But
the thing
anybody.
is that she has always gotten it, right? Like, yeah, we all get it. You know what I mean?
What do you mean?
What do you mean getting it? She's always.
I mean, we just by being in the public eye, no matter what level you're in, mm-hmm. oh, you're yeah. gonna get, you know, some. I mean, I get it still a lot.
Yeah, I learned it from this.
Yeah, podcast, yeah. But my point though is that it's like you can make fun of her comedy, maybe, you know what I mean, but to call her
just to be they're racist.
That's racist.
Mm-hmm. It just is. You and know, I'm glad she...
But why is it when people call me panda, I'm not that offended, but when black people are called monkeys, they get offended?
You know what? People have called me panda or even raccoon sometimes.
Yeah, or a koala. I go, oh, that's cool.
Yeah, I'm like, I laugh.
Yeah.
Why are we so accepting?
No, because there's... No, okay. It's fucking different.
It is.
Why?
It's fucking different because you have a completely different history than black people. You've had... You're a well-to-do Korean man that grew up in a fucking country club. The history of black people in America is
wink.
A yeah. fucking world away from your world. So there's a lot of, you know, different sensitivities in play. And I think that if I were black and if someone called me a monkey or an ape, I would be a fucking not, offended.
It's, I don't think it's that. I think that it's that pandas and koala bears are known as to be cute, right?
Mm-hmm.
And there's a negative connotation when it comes to monkeys because they're so close to our
gene pool,
right? And, you know, they're like the step below our evolution, you know? So there is a negative thing, but I don't even know why that would be negative, but I don't know.
Stop tweeting Leslie Jones bad things.
Yeah, just stop. Leave Leslie alone.
She's already off of Twitter.
Good for her, then.
And I don't think that she was necessarily offended because she's a comedian. She's heard it all. You know, I don't think that she left Twitter because, oh, God, this hurts. I think she was more in shock of shit. Last like, there are this many racist people. Motherfuckers yeah. in existence. Why do I want to be... a part of this, you know?
Richard Pryor did a roast once, and on the roast panel, it was Robin Williams was on the roast panel, but Marsha Warfield was on the roast panel.
Oh, I saw that one.
And yeah, I showed it to you. And Richard Pryor said, looks at Marsha Warfield, we got this one, you know, at the zoo, like she's a gorilla. And the place just is dying laughing. Mm-hmm. But the reason why, though, is because Richard Pryor is number one black, mm-hmm. all right? Number two, Marsha Warfield is her friend. They're very good friends, mm-hmm. right? And he's a comedian, so in that circumstance, you can say stuff like that, right? But if you're just fucking some white dude, you know what I mean, who drives a truck, shut the fuck up. You have no right. You're a loser. Sorry.
That's right, Daddy.
Okay, I like when he gets passionate.
I do too.
It's like his head shake. Like.
Yeah, well, he knows Leslie. That's his friend,
yeah.
so why
yeah,
would
it,
he?
Yeah, it infuriates me because, you know, she it takes so much... bravery and walking through fear to do stand up and whatever her dream is. And it's like for any fucking guy who is, you know, making fun of her, who hasn't done anything, makes yeah. me angry. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, these fucking keyboard
warriors
sitting on their fucking lazy boys just attacking people because they have nothing better to
they
do.
Should have
you
a
know?
Thing. They should have a thing. They should have a thing.
What's that thing?
You can comment, you can say, but you have to leave her address. That should be law.
Yeah, I think so. Yes. And I think that's...
Show me where you live.
GPS right? location.
You can call me a gook, but where are you?
Exactly.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And then if I know where you live, then that's fair. But these people are mysterious.
Some of them have no avatars, they have no pictures.
They're faceless.
And that's what infuriates me. I think that should be a law.
And you know, this is always my thing. For instance, anytime, like in the beginning when we first started recording, you mm-hmm. know, obviously I was very sensitive mm-hmm. before George or you would so read now, the comments. Yeah. I was very sensitive. So I would read, you know, certain fucking long ass essays written about me, you know, and I always think to myself, wow, this person, number one, doesn't have a name, didn't leave a real email address. Mm-hmm. But if I were to ever, if I wanted to so many times to write them back and say, hey, sit in front of me at a podcast, I dare you to sit next to Bobby Lee and attempt to banter with him for an hour in a podcast. I guarantee you, you will fucking crumble on the spot. I guarantee you. So for these people to always kind of tear me apart in the beginning, you know, because yeah, I'm not a comedian, and yeah, of course I'm Bobby's accessory, right?
No.
But,
no, his partner.
No, but I know I'm his partner, but I'm saying no. Like I dare you take my seat. If I could leave for 1 week,
bitch,
and take each person who's ever said anything.
You're not my accessory, you're bitch. Not my accessory, shut up.
Shut the fuck up.
I'm happy to be your accessory.
Bitch, no. The reason why, bitch, reason why I decided to do a fucking podcast with you, ding dong, is because of the fact that you can fucking do it, bitch. Okay? Yeah, Gilbert's not on this because he's Jenna's friend who happened to come to a UFC night. That's how I met him. No, we tried him the first time. He can do it, and that's why he is in it. George is here not because I met him at Makers, because he can produce the fucking thing.
Yeah,
they're all everyone in this thing is in it because they can do it. Okay, so that's that. Okay. Where are we out of time?
Not yet, sir.
God, I always, in my head, I always speak more eloquently.
Bitch, but you're not an accessory, bitch. Yeah.
No, but I'm happy to be, babe. That's all I'm saying. You're not an accessory. Your sidekick. I'm happy to, you know, just be here in our home and, you know, talk shit.
Talk shit?
Yeah. It's, anyways, sensitive subject.
Really quick MMA minute.
What?
Switch topics. This is Mark Hunt's statement. Because Brock Lesnar... tested positive.
I know.
Of course. You just look at his fucking body.
Duh.
This was the official statement he put on MMA Hour, Mark Hunt. Here's part of it. Well, this fucking white piece of shit sticking needles in his ass and say, oh, he's going to take all of us all the way to the fucking bank? Let's give him fucking millions of dollars and not worry about his motherfucker. You know what? Fuck that and fuck your shit company. Look at that for a contract. You can sue me on that, motherfuckers.
That was the Dana White. Good for him. Okay. Good for him, because they didn't allow John Jones to fight in that 200 card. They didn't allow Conor McGregor to fight because he missed a PR. Press conference. But they allow a juiced out Brock Lesnar, who they gave a window of exemption to not even test him.
Very tight one, yeah.
Right. And you allow him to take the fucking big bag of cash. In the meantime, Mark Hunt, who's risked his life against a fucking behemoth man, goes home with no fucking cash. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, it's absurd. Yeah. It's absurd. That company is so inconsistent and so mob-like that it's laughable. Well, I think that Dana White, you know, they sold the company for
change.
$4
billion. It's going to
change. Not only I honestly don't think he's... We want to go to UFC matches. I retract my statement.
You too.
We're friends. Okay, you're
White.
Okay.
Yeah, Mark Hunt. Don't talk like that.
Dana, you're doing a great job for the thing.
What he did to Ariel Helwani. You know what?
So what do you think about Mark Hunt saying that he's going to leave? He wants to leave the UFC.
He's not going
to
leave.
I think he'll leave.
No.
He wants half the purse.
I think that he should wait it out, because I think that a fighter's union is on its way.
What, he's going to fight boars in New Zealand? I mean... I mean, this guy,
come on,
what is
babe.
He going to do?
He's in his
40s. Take a spear, fucking throw a, you know what I mean?
A boar?
A little hula dress and he's dancing on the beach. Now get your shit together, Mark. Shut the fuck up.
Dana White's side?
I love him.
Because Joe Rogan is about to leave and they need a new commentator.
Really?
Joe's going to leave?
Yeah, he said he would leave if the UFC ever got bought out, and it fucking happened.
Here's what I want to say. What they did to Holly Holm.
Oh, my lord.
Holly Holm, right, it's done now for her.
It is.
It's done. She lost two in a row.
You think so?
Yeah, it's done. Yeah, because, like, she, number one, didn't defend her belt. Misha took it, right?
But then Misha didn't defend hers either.
Yeah, she's done. I think Misha's done. You know, I think Holly's done. And it's like they're just throwing these girls out there and they're using them up. And I think that they should have held on. Holly Holm should have just been champion, and waited for Ronda to come back and have, that big money fight. But she gets fucked.
No, I don't believe that. I think that, you know, well, if I were
fucked.
An athlete.
She got fucked financially.
Yeah, but she's a competitive woman. She wants to take a fight every 3 months, and I don't think there's anything wrong with her taking, you know, girls like Bullet or who's the last one she fought?
Tate.
Yeah, Misha.
She lost to Misha, yeah.
Yeah, it's like those are the girls in the top five, so why wouldn't they, or, you know?
Yeah.
Why
wouldn't she fight the best of the best? But now it's like, when is she going to fight next? Who's she going to fight?
Exactly.
She's going to be on some sort of fucking B card, you know what I mean? In some obscure night, Fox night.
You don't think she still has the whole, like, I beat Ronda Rousey thing?
No, I don't. Because I think that, first of all, is Ronda Rousey going to fight Holly Holm or Nunez?
True.
That's the first fight that Ronda's going to get.
I think Nunez is going to get Bullet next.
Probably.
And I think that Nunez is going to beat Bullet. I love Nunez.
She's great.
And no one's talking about how good Nunez is because of the fact that she... You know what I mean? Is
Brazilian or...
No.
She's a lesbian? She
scissors?
Yeah. Some other elements.
What other elements?
That she scissors?
No.
What is the other element?
Nothing.
I did everything bodily.
Oh, you're saying she's not pretty.
That's not what I'm saying.
That's exactly what you're saying.
There's a lot of different elements. No, I just think that she is somebody that has an accent. She does unholy activities in the bed with other women. And that, which is great. Has nothing to do with me. I love it. I support it. The LGBT.
Yeah,
and I believe that she's not a marketable face, right?
Well, she's also not American. She speaks English, but she's not a
Holly Holm, preacher's daughter, all American. You know, all those things play into a narrative, a storyline. Nunez is, you know, Brazilian.
Okay, but then that begs the question:
she is Brazilian.
Do you want to just see good fights, or do you want a narrative? Like for
no,
me,
I'm saying I love Nunez.
No, what I'm saying is, you know, if we're always talking about marketability, that's gonna, you know, you're not prioritizing good fights, you're prioritizing the narrative. Mm. You know, so you're operating like a business rather than a real sport.
Well, it's for me, it's like, it is a business. And you're the one that taught me about Conor McGregor. Mm. All right, I was at that point of view before Conor McGregor. I was like, it should be based on integrity.
Yeah.
But it's not. It's an entertainment sport. And Conor McGregor, you know, is an entertainer and he has revitalized that sport. I think John Jones is an entertainer. I think that the stuff that he does, running over a pregnant lady and all those other
things, part of the narrative.
Is a part of the narrative and it makes it like exciting and weird.
He ran over a pregnant lady, George.
Yeah. And I think guys like Luke Rockhold, who's like just this guy, I love him, but
it's a robot,
there's really he's just like a good-looking white dude that really
surfs.
Isn't, you know, he skateboards. It's not really doesn't fit into any kind of thing. You know, he's a nice guy. Cormier too. They're all nice guys. That whole camp actually,
AKA Cain Velasquez.
Yeah, they're
AKA,
all just nice guys. Dudes, they're all friends. And also, it's a white guy, a black guy, and a Mexican, and they're all together and they're best friends. Yeah, it's a sitcom.
It's a sitcom.
I don't like it. I don't like it.
Oh man!
But I think Conor. I think what Johanna Jędrzejczyk did for that
Claudia
fight
narrative.
Was what? Yeah, what she was doing? What she was learned it from the Conor blueprint.
Yeah, I think that it's good to be both, to understand the business and to be the best fighter. So if you're in the top five, come up with a personality, come up with an alter ego, or come up with a great story for yourself, because that's just going to make you, this isn't a big money making sport. So it's like, get it while you can, while your name is hot. So if I was Holly Holm, I would have probably ran over a pregnant lady too.
Yeah. I think Jose Aldo, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Is now beginning.
He's starting.
He grew a mustache.
That was hilarious.
No, I'm not kidding you.
It was funny though.
Oh, you're laughing
at
that.
Do you think he's trying to be a villain now?
He looks a little like Moriarty.
Old-timey.
Like Sherlock Holmes, you villain. He grew a mustache. He's trying to speak English now.
Which is weird.
And he's calling out Conor McGregor when Conor McGregor's not even
fighting
him in his division, you know? So now, like, Jose Aldo looks like a crazy person.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And he's like, he's in the movie, you know, they're making a movie. They were almost done with the movie. Do you know that about him?
Oh yeah, no.
Yeah, they in Brazil. I mean, if they had an actor that played him, and they were shooting the movie, And when he lost to Conor McGregor, they stopped production.
Oh, really?
On the movie, yeah. Which only made him crazier, probably.
Yeah.
And now he probably just talks to himself in a mirror, and now he's turning into a fucking
psychopath.
Psychopath. And we like it. We want.
We fucking love it.
And what we saw him against Frankie Edgar was a different kind of fighter, I believe. You know, yeah. I love.
Maybe.
He looked good.
No, he looked so good.
You know what's
he
really
different.
Disgusting?
What?
That one. You blew a piece of food into the mic. And you just plucked it
where
out.
Where are we at time-wise?
Time for a question.
Yeah, we are.
Unhopeful advice with with Bobby and Khalyla. Hi, guys. This is from Azar. How can I be part of an Asian circle of friends? I always see you guys at school in a big group, and you seem to be having so much fun.
Is this a white guy?
Azar.
Possibly. Let's maybe. Assume he's white. Let's
there
assume
is always
he's white.
A, you guys always have a lot of energy. I'm not Asian, but I occasionally see non-Asians in groups, so I have hope. It generally seems like it's an exclusive club. I sometimes hang out with whites, but it's only a couple of them, and they always want to watch movies, TV, and etc., and are generally pretty boring. What is the secret to making friends with Asians? Thanks. Bobby Lee?
If you ever watch Mitch Mullaney, he is a comic. He has a joke about that, that one white guy that's you know, that hangs out with Asians. Mm-hmm. Like he's like more Asian than them.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm hungry, guy. You know what I mean?
Likes he anime.
Big, yeah, he likes anime, yeah. Don't be that guy. You know, it's like, you know, we live in America. I don't hang out with Asians. Mm-hmm. My friends are.
You think he's fetishizing?
I think he is. Right?
If you want to hang out with a large group of Asians and you want to fit into that, that's a fetish. You know, for me, it's like, the only Asians I hang out with is you guys, David Cho, my brother. That's pretty much
and
it.
And growing up, not really.
Didn't really have. I had a lot of white friends, mm-hmm. Mexican friends, and. A lot of my friends in stand-up are all white and black and Mexican. I don't really hang out with other. Yeah. I mean, I'll see Ali Wong. We're friends. You know what I mean? She's cool. But I don't look at her and go, wow, there's an Asian girl.
Yeah.
Steve Burns, half Asian. I don't really see him as that.
I don't have a proper answer for this question.
Because you grew up in, yeah, with Asians.
Well, no. And also when I came from the Philippines for the first time, the Filipinos all rejected me. I was too fobby. I wasn't I was too Filipino. My accent was too thick. And I don't know. I probably didn't dress cool. I didn't shave my legs. There were a lot of like social things that I didn't catch up to. No, because I didn't know that. I didn't. Yeah. I only ever shaved for swim meets because we had to. But I didn't know that boys liked shaved legs here. I didn't know a lot of things, and I probably dressed a little backwards because my parents we had already lost a lot of our money, and I dressed like. Kid from the Philippines.
When I first talked to Khalyla on the phone, she goes, sorry about my accent. She yeah. said
aww,
that.
Right
made,
away?
It made me go, aww.
Yeah, I was very insecure for a while because I had hard consonants and I was always called out for it. So when I was in a swim team, we would have to scream out our times to our coach. So let's say like I do like a 50 butterfly, right? And I'd have to say like,
Khalyla, what's your time?
Yeah, 26.2, right? And I was so insecure.
How'd it come out?
26.2. And so I would go home and practice this at 20, 20, 20, 20, Oregon or mountain. Because I would say mountain.
Oh my God.
No, Frigidaire. I would say refrigerator. Like I would practice my hard T's because, it matters when you're 14 and 15 and people are like, where the fuck are you from? Well, you don't look Filipino. And the Filipinos would say, well, you're too Filipino. So you know who I hung out with?
Jessica.
No, Jessica. She was my only Korean friend, but she didn't even go to the same school. I only hung out with Mexicans. LA. Mexicans took me in, didn't give a fuck. I went to more quinceañeras than
It's so any... funny that you say that. Because in comedy, there was a time where you had to be either Mexican, black, or white in the 90s, and the Mexicans took me in. Oh, I did Latino Laugh Festival.
Factions.
Yeah,
okay.
I did. It's like in prison mm-hmm. when you're like Asian and you're like, I gotta join a clan. They go with the Mexicans or protect themselves. Yeah. That's what happened to me.
Mexicans.
Yeah, Mencia, Willie Barcena, Jeff Garcia, Gabriel, Felipe Esparza, all those guys I started with because they were the only ones that took me in. Because the white ones, I wasn't nerdy enough. Or cool enough, like Dane was the thing then, and the black ones, no. So the Mexicans harbored me.
Dude, but also Mexicans just have a really, really deep sense of family. And a lot of the Mexican kids that I hung out with, their families were immigrants, right? Or they were illegal here. So So we kind of just bonded in that same sense where it's like, oh, I was new to the country. Their parents were illegal immigrants, and cool. I just partied with them all the time. Bien, and for bien, a los, while there, los I swear pantalones.
To you. La escuela.
Probably your Spanish is
Mexicans
very
Mexicans are my people,
so
man.
I love them. I love Mexicans so much,
me
dude.
Too.
I really do.
They're inclusive.
Yeah,
they're
really
full
cool.
of. They're full of party in their heart. Yeah, I love Mexicans.
I love Mexicans.
I don't. You know what I'm not a fan of? And I'm going to get a lot of shit for this.
Be careful.
Chinese.
No, I'm not a fan oh, of.
Oops. Oops.
Super.
We know what Bobby doesn't like.
Well, we know that. A lot of Filipinos that live in California.
Whoa.
I would
baby,
never.
Take
you will
that back.
Never catch me dating a Filipino guy either.
That's insane.
There's something about this sense of righteousness that the Filipinos who were born here have that is a complete turnoff.
California ones.
Yeah, it's like they kind of all bond together because they have this Filipino clique, but they know nothing about the Philippines as a country. They know nothing about the history. They know nothing about the language, but they're very kind of like cliquish. And they're like, oh, but this is all this is a flip crew. This is a Pinoy crew. I'm like, no, you're not. Because to them, I'm not Filipino looking enough, but I'm too Filipino acting. And they're the ones who kind of, they're the ones who go back to the Philippines and have a, this kind of air like, oh, but we're the Americanized Filipinos. And I hate that bullshit.
Mm. I want to just say this because you said Filipino, right? Mm-hmm. I just want to say, anyone, if you're going to come up to me and recognize me, don't go, hey, aren't you on YouTube? Because what that does is it negates everyone's on YouTube.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
That's what a Filipino dude at a Mexican restaurant in Sacramento said that to me. Hey, dude, aren't you on YouTube? I go, yeah, you are too.
George Kimmel is as well.
George Kimmel, I think YouTube. Everyone's on YouTube, right?
If you say, hey, weren't you on Mad TV or even Comedy Central is vague, but...
Say that.
Yeah, don't say YouTube.
And that's the word. Shows for Bobby Khalyla?
Oh, that's right. In 2 weeks, Bobby is going to be at the Arlington Draft House in Virginia. And the week after that, he is going to be at Helium Comedy Club in Philadelphia. Mm-hmm. And those are the only two dates I have right now. I also want to let everyone know that if you go into our Instagram account, we are having a logo contest.
Oh.
And the contest ends a little bit under 2 weeks from now. Go to Instagram and find the details there. I'm going to repost it probably sometime this week. And anybody can enter. You don't have to be this... great artists to submit. Yeah. I mean, I even drew something up and...
Well, you're like an artist.
Right. So we don't necessarily know what we want. The only rules is no tiger. So,
just... Whatever this means to you. Whatever Tiger Belly means to you.
Yeah.
In picture form.
Right. So throw us your ideas. And so that contest ends in 2 weeks. Also, we are looking for somebody to... Is it called a web developer?
Yeah.
To help us with our website. And if you're interested in helping us with our website and you have
experience
with Shopify, email us at thetigerbelly.com. Tigerbelly@gmail.com.
Yeah, thetigerbelly@gmail.com.
Right, right.
And also, if you have any questions, you can send your questions there for unhelpful advice. You can also follow us on Instagram at TigerBelly and on Twitter at TheTigerBelly. And also, if you want to mail us anything so we can open up in the vlog, or if you want us to get Khalyla a new hat, because Khalyla's on a hat streak right now.
I am.
If you guys want to send a hat for her to wear on the podcast, she might wear it. George, do you want anything?
I also...
He wants Magnum
condoms. Oh, you know
condoms,
what I want?
Because his dick is huge.
I really want Harmless Harvest coconut water. I'm really thankful for this particular one. But for the next round, if you can get me Harmless Harvest, that'd be nice.
And also, you can send us the stuff at 1626 North Wilcox Avenue, Unit 161, Hollywood, California, 90028. And also, you can follow Khalyla on all social media at Calamity K if you like videos of cats and Bobby massaging her legs.
And today, I snapped. A pic of snap of him naked.
Ooh, Nakey. Bobby's penis is on her Snapchat.
Yes, if
check
you
want to
see
out.
His penne, you can.
Her penne pasta.
Yeah.
And if you want to follow anyone else on this podcast or people that have been on this podcast, just go to our Instagram and hit follow, and we're all there.
Yep, we are. Thank you for listening, and we hope you guys have a wonderful week. We will see you next time.
Bye.
Ciao. Kau dapat kami urubi Buro kaya kapag nandun lukma Syukur lukma lai Sukut juga kumul pakaki Syukumula kau dapat kami urubi Buro kaya kapag nandun lukma